Let us face, without panic, the reality of our times. The fact that atom bombs may someday be dropped on our cities. And let us prepare for survival, understanding the weapon that threatens us. An atom bomb destroys or injures in three ways. By blast, heat, and radioactivity. The blast of an atom bomb is most important destructive agent. In Japan, whole buildings were flattened by its force. However, many buildings of sturdy construction, even though most of the explosion, remained standing. The principal dangers of blast are flying glass and debris. The fire that may start, and the danger of being crushed in collapsing buildings. The atom bomb destroys by heat. People caught in the open as far as 2 miles away suffered flame burns. Yet, protection could have been easily achieved. Here, a bridge post and rail shielded the surface behind it. Any solid material afforded similar protection. The third weapon of the bomb is radioactivity, thrown off at the instant of explosion. However, the majority of people exposed to radiation recovered completely, including a large percentage of those who suffered serious radiation sickness. Today, they lead normal lives. They bear children. Their children are normal. These, then, are the weapons of the atom bomb that we must protect against. Blast, heat, and radioactivity. Our cities are prime targets for atomic attacks. But mass evacuation would be different. An enemy would like nothing better than to have us leave our cities empty and unproductive. If an emergency should come, our factory will be battle station. Production must go on if we are to win. Our officers and homes will also be posts of duty, not to be deserted. With the knowledge of the first atomic explosion to guide us, our chances for survival will be far better than those of the people of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, if we act on our knowledge and are prepared. The first job is to look over your own home for shelter possibilities. If you live in a private home that is well built, the cellar is the safest place to be. The lower you get, the more barriers there are likely to be against blast, heat, and radioactivity. Select the basement wall nearest the probable target area of your city. If the house is blown over, it will most likely fall away from this wall. If you have a workbench or strong table big enough to get under, move it into your shelter area near a wall or strong supporting column. If the time comes when you actually have to take shelter, lie under the table. If you live in a home that has no basement, choose a shelter area without windows on the ground floor. An interior hallway is probably best. In time of emergency, the shelter area should be cleared of mirrors and other objects that might cause injury. If you live in an apartment house, rules for taking shelter will be posted in your building. Learn them. Also, learn the location of public shelters in areas where you work or frequently visit. There are many things you can begin doing right now. Fireproof housekeeping is one. So clean up that attic. Keep waste in covered containers. Don't let trash pile up in the yard. Set aside a small supply of canned goods. They're safe from radioactivity. Have a good flashlight on hand. Electric lights may go out.